guys, this is Milo, and I know it's been a very long time since I've done a video on YouTube. I'm glad to be back, and I want to say hi to all my subscribers and YouTubers out there that are watching my videos for the first time. So I'm glad to be back, and I just want to say hi to everybody, and let's go ahead and start this review. Anyways, guys, today I wanted to show you, or I wanted to talk about the Dark Knight, the original costume. If I'm not mistaken, this was not directly sold here in the United States. DC Direct had not yet had an agreement with Hot Toys, so this was distributed only in Asia. And I believe they were released or produced in limited quantities. I don't know the exact amount, but there weren't very many made compared to a regular Hot Toys collectible. It's a very nice costume. This is the costume that you saw at the beginning of The Dark Knight, and he wore in Batman Begins. Now, Hot Toys did release a Hot Toys Batman Begins collectible. The same costume, but I believe the collectibles are different. I don't know what exactly, but from what I've read, this one's far superior and better. I may or may not get the Batman Begins collectible. I'll have to see. I know I've read the forums. A lot more people like the Takara. Batman. Anyways, here's what you get. You get the sleeve, the open window here. We get to see a little preview of the Batman. I've already removed them. I've had them for a while. And there you have it. Now, let me begin by saying, guys, that I really love this suit. Now, I don't like it as much as the updated separation of the plate suit that he wore later on in the Dark Knight movie. But I still love this suit. I love the design and how it all comes together. Now, let me begin by saying that you do not want to leave this guy, you know, exposed outside without it being in a display case. This dude is a dust magnet, and right now, like, you can even see, like, dust just start to gather on this dude. So you definitely want to keep this guy behind glass. I had another one before, and I know the previous owner did not take very good care of it. He just had it laying around on his desk, and when I got it, the dude was almost white, because he had, I mean, just all the dust all over him. I mean, it was kind of funny, and really hard to clean, so you definitely, again, want to keep him in a glass container. Again, I really love the suit. I love the design of this Hot Toys original costume Batman. Looks fantastic. He only comes with one utility belt. It's different from the others that we've seen, and I'll give you a close-up here in a little bit. He comes with two batarangs, which you can actually remove, and he has a little batarang holder right here that you can just place right there in his utility belt. And he also has like a cell phone type device you'll see here on the side. And just like the DX or the MMS-71 Batman, you can place the grapple gun back here in the back in his utility belt. And let me just give you a look at the back. Let's see what he looks like. As you can see, this is different from the DX version or the updated Batman suit. The cape is the same material that we've seen with all, you know, is it Batman or Batman costumes? Other than, of course, the Batman Demon, which is a different type of material. This looks phenomenal. I really love the way it looks. You really want to keep from posing this guy too much because of the creases of the suit. I believe these creases come as is. You know, when you first buy them, these creases are going to be here. But they do get worse, I think, if you pose them too much or if you leave them in a certain pose. The creases will be harder than normal. As far as accessories, guys, it comes with several hands. It comes with the hands that you see here, one for the batarangs, and open articulated hand here. The fingers don't move, but very, very nice pose. I like that hand there. He comes, I believe, no, he doesn't. He comes with two closed fists and a relaxed right hand and a hand for the grapple gun. He comes with the mine, or the grenade type thing. And then he comes with the pneumatic mangler that you saw at the beginning of The Dark Knight. Real cool device. I mean, I don't really want to pose them with this thing, but it's a cool little accessory if you're into that kind of thing, if you want to pose with this thing. Not a lot to it, really, but I mean, it looks cool, movie accurate. You can bend it down here so that you can get it, you know, when you have to begin the movie and grabbed onto the white van. You can pose it with the hand right there, which looks really cool. And then, of course, comes with the Christian Bale head, which I believe this is, let me get a close-up, which I believe this is one of the most popular head sculpts, I think, I don't know. I kind of see Christian Bale a little bit, but these are not as good as the recent head sculpts that Hot Toys has produced. The skin texture is not as good as what we've seen, of course. I mean, this is an older collectible, but I mean, it's still nice. And all right, now let's take a little closer look, a little close-up. You can kind of see the dust already kind of just sprinkled here and there. So this dude will be heading back as soon as possible. And that's just, that looks fantastic. The skin texture, the expression on the suit, I mean, extremely realistic. Hot Toys did a phenomenal job with the mask right there. Looks really, really good. That's phenomenal. And of course, in the Dark Knight movie, you know, that's one of the complaints that he had with the suit was he had minimal head movement, and you can see why. I mean, you can't even turn the head on this one. When you watch the movie, I mean, he had very little head movement, which was one of the reasons that he wanted the updated suit. And you can kind of see the dust right there, guys. Look at that. This is pretty good considering, you know, I got this guy used. The guy before me did have him in a display case. But all it takes is a couple of seconds, and this dude will get dust quick. There's that little cell phone type device I was talking about. Really like the suit. Really, really do like it. Hot Toys did a really good job. And this guy actually does have good articulation. He can sustain and hold some poses. But however, it is limited, like most Hot Toys Batman costume collectibles. The costume just kind of keeps you from doing all the poses that you want because it's limited. I mean, the rubber will only let you move the hand, the elbows at certain degrees, so you're not going to get complete articulation like the bodies were intended to because of the costumes, but still phenomenal. You can still do some nice poses with this collectible. I just kind of wanted to add some information, and maybe this will be helpful for you guys that are looking to purchase one or all of these. And let me start off by saying that I think all three of these are unbelievable collectibles, and they're worth every penny. But by far, the best costume out of these three, or the best Hot Toys Batman collectible, is the DX. I mean, it's not even close, in my opinion. And, I mean, what they did with the DX is a phenomenal, unbelievable recreation of the original, or not the original, but the separated plate costume from the movie. And I guess one of the reasons that I wanted to make this video is that I saw recently that... Well, for those of you that don't know, the one in the middle, that's the DX. The one on your left is the MMS-71 Batman. That was the first Batman released in that suit version. And then you have the original on the right. Now, again, the reason I wanted to make this video was because I saw recently that the MMS-71 Batman, this one here, started selling for, or went up in value quite a bit. And I think one of the reasons is because people are afraid of buying the DX Batman because of all the defects and all the infamous, the oil suit, the ears, and all that stuff. And so people are kind of scared and staying away from the DX. So I kind of wanted to just let you know what to look for if you're buying the DX Batman. You know, how can you tell if you're getting the defected or the United States or the perfect batch Batman? And there's a real easy way to tell. Because if you can choose between this and you only want one, well, I think it's obvious that you go with the DX. And I'll explain why in a little bit. But a real easy way to tell that you're getting the perfect batch Batman from whoever you're buying it from is ask him to take a picture of not the abs, but of his belt. If it's a brand new collectible. And a lot of you already know this. This is just for the people that don't know. If the utility belt is wrapped with plastic all the way around, front and back, the entire thing is wrapped, then you're buying the defected Batman. That's going to have the oily abs and all the issues that we've come to see, or at least most of them. The updated version, when Hot Toys released it, they updated it and they revised it. What they did was they didn't wrap the entire utility belt. They only put a plastic-like sticker behind the utility belt. So you actually technically, the front was exposed. There's no wrap out here in the front. So that's a real easy way, a really quick way to see if you're getting the defected or the, you know, the perfect DX Batman. And out of these two suits, I mean, by far the DX is superior to the MMS 71. I mean, this dude looks like he's way beefier. Looks like a Herculean Batman compared to this one. This one is slender, looks athletic, and more proportional to Christian Bale's body. This one right here, I mean, this dude looks like he's... I mean, you probably can't tell on camera, but this dude looks like he's on steroids. He looks extremely... a lot bigger body frame. And just doesn't look right. I mean, he looks way too bulky and too big. Now, it does look good. I mean, it's an amazing suit. It looks phenomenal, but it's just not as good as the DX. The DX is just, I mean, it's unbelievable, way superior. If you want to collect all of them, then, I mean, go for it and get all three. But it's just funny how I've seen the MMS 71 rise in value just because people don't know what they're getting. They're scared to get the DX. So I just wanted to share that information out there for you guys. You know, how to tell if you're getting the defected or the perfect Batman. So hopefully that was helpful, guys, and I just wanted to share that a little bit of information. Hey guys, with you. There you have it. I hope you enjoyed this short review, and thanks for watching. I will have more reviews coming. I do have other collectibles that I have not reviewed that I have. So sometime soon I'll do some of those. I have some Iron Man stuff that I will show you. And for those of you that are waiting for the Falconer Predator review, I just haven't got it yet. I'm waiting. I have it pre-ordered. It just hasn't arrived. So as soon as I get it, I will do my thoughts and comments on Falconer Predator, and that'll be up as soon as I get it. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and hope you come back.